Hello, Saggies. I hope you guys are doing awesome wherever you are. So you want a soulmate reading? That's what we're going to do. We're going to ask about your soulmate, whether you are currently in contact with them or not. In the first half of this video, we're going to ask what's coming towards you, what you be dealing with, facing, how to best handle it for your highest good. And then the second half of this video, we're going to ask about your soulmate, whether you're currently in contact with them or not. We're going to ask what's going on with your soulmate, how they are currently relating to you at this time, especially emotionally, what's on their mind as well, what they're thinking, feeling. So let's do this, Saggies. Universe, please step in, show very clear and important messages for the sign of Sagittarius. For Sagittarius, highest good, please. Universe, what's coming towards Saggies? What's coming towards Sagittarius? What will Sagittarius be dealing with, facing, and how to best handle it for their highest good? What is coming towards Sagittarius? Wow. So this is very important because it fell out during shuffling judgment. And coincidentally, I don't know if you saw, if you were able to see before I started the reading, this card was underneath. So judgment, for a lot of you, there will be reconciliation, meaning making peace. Wow. I don't read reversals usually, but occasionally my guides will reverse cards on me to show me messages that they need me to see for people. So reversed Eight of Cups, you're not willing or not ready to walk away from this soulmate relationship at this time. Yeah, you're not ready to walk away. So reconciliation is showing up for a lot of you. Reconciliation truly means communicating and making peace with each other. Yeah, that's what reconciliation means. It doesn't always mean being together as a couple. Reconciliation truly means communicating effectively, honestly with each other, and making peaceful agreements with each other. And then the two people will decide what they want to be to each other in their life. Doesn't always mean, oh, let's get back together. So a lot of people misunderstand that. They think reconciliation means they're going to be back together. So for those of you who just want to make peace with this person, not want to be in a relationship, whatever it is that you desire, reconciliation, making peace with the other person is always good. It's always good to have this good energy around you, not feel any type of regret or resentment. Yeah. So let's do this. Universe, what's coming towards Sagittarius? What will Sagittarius be dealing with, facing? What's coming towards Saggies? You have one extra popping out for you. Unexpected messages showing up. So all pages are messengers. Page of Wands represents messages that are unexpected, quick, also passionate communication of some sort. Wow. So this is you feeling regretful about some of the things, feeling sad, regretful, not able to rest, not able to put things behind you in a peaceful way. This is you being troubled, regretful about things. Yeah. This is apologies also, peace offerings, explanations, and you being happy with the resolution. So a lot of you will be reaching out, or maybe the other person will be reaching out, or maybe you bump into each other and make some kind of peaceful agreement with this person. And this is victory, victorious energy. Some of you will be getting important messages that you are expecting, but thinking maybe you won't get, but you would like to get, about something important to you in your life, and you're going to celebrate, because here's the celebration victory card, Six of Wands, and also Ten of Cups. Something, some kind of message. For some of you, it will be about your soulmate. For some of you, it will be about a job or promotion, a business deal, something that will make you very happy. Wow, look at this. Messages, more pages. Wow, you have deep regrets about something, Sagis. So there were some serious mistakes that were made in your soulmate relationship, with whether it was done by you, by the other party, or both of you, and you have deep regrets. Sadness is showing up here, deep regrets. Both of these represent very deep regrets. Nine of Swords with Five of Cups. You love this person. You deeply love this person, but are not telling this individual that you love them, that you still love them. Here's the King of Cups. This is you showing with the King of Cups and Page of Cups, wanting to extend some kind of love gesture or emotional offer to your soulmate. My goodness, it would make both of you happy. Look at this, Ten of Cups twice from two different tarot decks on each other. So this reconciliation that showed up earlier would make both of you happy to make some kind of peaceful agreement with each other. And then you can decide if you want to be in each other's lives and as what. Yeah, a new beginning is possible if you guys take appropriate actions. Wow, don't let your pride prevent you from reaching out to this person. Yeah, our pride and ego can be sometimes our worst enemy. So don't let your pride stop you from extending the olive branch to your soulmate. Yeah, so you still want to fight for this connection. You feel heartbreak though. Oh my goodness. You view this person as lifetime commitment that you would like to have. Ten of Cups, Ten of Cups, and Ten of Wands. I'm sorry, Ten of Pentacles. This is a lifetime commitment that you were hoping for or are still hoping for to have with this person. For a lot of you, you're still hoping to have this with this person because you're showing up here as King of Cups with Page of Cups. You want to reconnect with this person and be in their life, physically present in their life. Yeah, you're capable of taking action. Yeah, so you know, you can feel that this is a soulmate connection. And it is. The two of you were romantically involved in other lifetimes with this lover card over here, lover's card. Wow, what a connection you have with this person. A lot of you Sagis feel you owe this person an apology or explanation or both. Don't let your pride or ego stop you from doing so, okay? We all make mistakes. Every single person on this planet makes mistakes. The point is to admit them, learn from them, and not repeat them. So let's see. This is beautiful. Victory, celebration of something important, some kind of milestone in your life. Universe, please clarify these energies for Sagittarius, highest good. Again, Page of Swords. So you checking up on your soulmate. This is the second time it's showing up. This is you checking up on your soulmate. A lot of you are dealing with Leo, Virgo, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, also Aries, Sagittarius showing up here, also Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. So, wow. So a lot of you walked away from this person physically, mentally, but not emotionally. You are not giving up on this person. Your heart has not given up on this person. So you still love this person, but you walked away maybe mentally and physically, or they walked away from you. Look at this, the Sun, the best energy in the whole deck. So you have a chance. And look at this, Wheel of Fortune. So you have a chance to resolve this successfully. Yeah, you have a chance to resolve this successfully. So you feel like you are stuck right now, not making any type of movement. But it looks like the both of you still love each other. So this is mutual. It's not just you feeling love for this person. The person is feeling love for you. But there's not much movement going on right now. Not much going on between the two of you. no conversation. Yeah, let's see what's going on with your soulmate. Very curious. This is nice. Let me see, Sagis. Universe, please step in. Show very clear and important messages for Sagittarius' highest good. Universe, the soulmate of Sagittarius. The soulmate of Sagittarius. No matter what sign or gender they are collectively. What is going on with the soulmate of Sagittarius? And how is the soulmate of Sagittarius currently relating to Sagittarius, especially emotionally? What's going on with the soulmate? Seven of Pentacles. So this person has been waiting on communication from you. They've been waiting for a long time and patiently. A lot of you are dealing with another Sag, also Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. Wow, this person viewed you as their lifetime commitment they wanted to have. Marriage, living together, very serious relationship they wanted to have. Maybe they still do. Yeah, they haven't let you go either. So they haven't released you either. This person has not released you. They still care for you deeply. They haven't fully released you, no. A lot of you are dealing again with Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Universe, please clarify these energies. What's going on with the soulmate of Sagittarius? And how is the soulmate of Sagittarius currently relating to Sagis, especially emotionally? Yeah, they feel exhausted from waiting, waiting, waiting. They feel tired, exhausted, beat up. But this person has not given up. No, they have not given up with this Nine of Wands and Four of Pentacles. You look at this twice. You have Hierophant from this person. So this person was hoping in the past that the two of you would end up in a lifetime union, like marriage or living together. Yeah, look at this. So you got the Hierophant twice from them and the Seven of Wands, Seven of Pentacles twice from them. So this person is still hoping, wishing that this will be coming to fruition. This person has not given up on you. Yeah, you see, Ten of Pentacles, just like you got. So this person still views you as the ultimate soulmate. Yeah, this person has not given up. Yeah, they are concentrating on business though, heavily concentrating on money, finances, financial prosperity. This person is still in love with you, but is not telling you that they still love you. So this is unspoken love, secret love, unexpressed love. Yeah, they would be willing to come in with love offer if you would show them that you are still interested, but are silent. Here is silence showing up here. A lot of you are dealing with somebody who is very spiritual, intuitive, good with energy. This person is not communicating what they're feeling for you. They're silent about it. Yeah. Look at this. Two aces. All aces are good. This person feels like they've been holding on, just waiting there patiently. They're keeping tabs on you, spying on you, checking up on you. Could be any way they can, whether through videos like this or social media or mutual acquaintances or your work. Yeah. Look at this. So this person suspects that you still love them. But they're very guarded emotionally. They're very guarded. A lot of you are dealing with the Cancerian, also Pisces showing up here. Very strong Scorpio energy. This person feels that you still love them, but you're purposely silent about it. Yeah, look at this. Unexpected messages showing up here. Look at this. So this person has been waiting and wishing to get some kind of emotional message from you, letting them know or showing them that you still care emotionally. They're very guarded though. Yeah, they don't know what's going to happen. Yeah, they're very guarded. They're concerned that if they reach out to you, that you are going to reject them or show them you don't appreciate anything about them. Although they suspect that you still love them, but are not certain. This person has not given up, and neither have you. Let's see more for you, Sagis. Then we're going to go into your extended. Universe, please show us more. More for Sagittarius, highest good. Yeah, this is you feeling deep regrets about something that transpired. Yeah, you are regretful deeply about some of the things that happened. Yeah, but this is you loving your soulmate, very emotional towards your soulmate, reminiscing about them very often. This also shows past life connection. The two of you were connected in other lifetimes. Wow. Don't let your pride, Sagis, keep you away from your soulmate, away from communication. Communicate. You have the ability to repair this. You have the ability to have a new beginning if that's what you guys choose. Don't let your pride stop you from reaching out. Yeah, this is you scared, fearful, over-analytical. Yeah, you see, Nine of Swords again from two different tarot decks. And this is you being fearful, scared, over-analyzing. Even for those of you Sagis that when you reach out to this person, extend the olive branch and the person rejects you, at least you will know that you tried your best and you'll be able to get some kind of closure. But it looks like this person loves you, even though they are highly disappointed and hurt. This person loves you. Sagis, we're going to go into your extended reading and ask about your soulmate's current true long-term intentions and plans for you at this time. We're going to ask what they're hiding from you, what they have up their sleeve, whether they're hiding it on purpose or can't communicate for whatever reason. But the universe feels you need to be aware of for your highest good. And of course, at the end, we're going to ask advice for you from universe, from spirit, on how to best handle this soulmate connection at this time. And anything else you need to know about your life, whether it's your health, finances, business, job opportunities, family matters, whatever it is you need to know, they'll show it at the end of the reading as well. So Sagis, click on the extended link below this video in the description box below, and I'll see you there. Thank you, guys.